morning, CMS, and welcome to the October 4th edition of Crest News Network. We'd like to start by wishing Mr. Alkani a very happy birthday.
At the top of the news, Crest Memorial students are gearing up for the Week of Respect, which takes place all next week. Here with a report on that event is Sonia Elliott.
Good morning, Crest Memorial. As you all know, next week is Week of Respect. Students are encouraged to wear the clothes for the following days. Monday, October 7th, Crest Memorial takes bullying seriously. Come dressed to impress. Tuesday, October 8th, wear your brightest clothes. Don't worry about matching. Wednesday, October 9th is School Spirit Day. Wear Crest Memorial colors. Thursday, October 10th, standing up to bullies is no sweat. Wear sweat clothes. And finally, Friday, October 11th, team up against bullying. Represent your favorite sports teams, and that includes hats. We look forward to seeing everyone's outfits next week.
Rehearsals for the school play are coming along nicely, Director Ms. Rucci reports, and the cast is working hard to make their production of Frozen Jr. the best it can be. Some of the leading roles are Anna, played by Mia Massey, Elsa, played by Amelia Renzack, Olaf, played by Monica Kobrowski, Kristoff, played by Madden Fusilero, Sven, played by Daniel Sandin, and Oaken, played by Kiana Walden. We are all looking forward to this year's play, which will be performed November 21st, 22nd, and 23rd.
Eighth graders vying for student council office gave their speeches to the middle school peers yesterday. Voting will take place this morning in homerooms for students in grades 6 through 8. Winners will be announced later today.
Crest Memorial will be hosting a flu shot clinic this coming Tuesday, October 8th. Here with more information about the clinic is Maggie Davenport, who interviewed school nurse Mrs. Sorensen.
So, Ms. Sorensen, why do you think flu shots are important for kids to get?
Well, the flu is very, very contagious, and in a school environment where there's lots of kids in close contact, coughing and sneezing, it can spread very quickly. So a flu vaccine can prevent that.
Okay. So what's the difference between getting your flu shot at the doctor's office and at school?
There is no difference. It doesn't matter where you get it from.
What viruses does a flu shot protect?
Just the flu virus, no other viruses.
Is there any difference between getting flu shots as an adult or a child?
No difference, just that children under 1 year of age get a smaller dose in two different shots.
What are the symptoms of flu shots?
The flu shot itself?
Yes.
Or the flu? Okay, so the flu shot is one quick little pinch needle. The needle doesn't hurt much at all, and then your arm just might be a little sore for the next 24 hours or so. Symptoms of the flu are a fever, a very runny nose, cough, congestion, very, very severe muscle weakness, and being tired.
So for our last question, when will flu shots be given at school?
So on Tuesday, October 8th, from 3 to 4 o'clock, the health department will be here at Crest Memorial School giving out free flu vaccines to anybody in the community who would like to come in and get them.
Okay, so you heard it. Bye.
A huge congratulations to the Crest Memorial's Iron teachers, Ms. Stocker and Ms. Tomlin, who completed the Maryland Ironman competition on September 28th. After training for nearly a year. These two teachers spent almost 15 nonstop hours to complete 140.6 miles. They swam 2.4 miles, then biked 112 miles. Oh, and they ran a marathon of 26.2 miles. They joined Mr. Smith, who completed the course last year, as the school's iron teachers. Well done.
Again, a stop on the route of the Run for the Fallen, which honors military men and women who gave their lives in service to their country. The marker at CMS is in memory of Salvatore Corma, who was killed in combat on April 29, 2010 in Afghanistan. He was 24 years old. His mother attended the ceremony and spoke about her son. The flag-raising ceremony held during the event was in honor of U.S. Navy veteran Elmer Geiger, who was born April 23, 1908 and died February 24, 1992.
Moving on to sports, the cross-country team is doing great. The girls' team has won both meets with only Crest girls in the top five. Even though the boys haven't won yet, they all have had very strong finishes. The soccer team has also been doing an amazing job. At the time of this taping, they had a win against North Wildwood, tied with Wildwood, and a loss to Pilgrim Academy.
That's all the news we have for this episode. Be sure to watch us again in 2 weeks on the Crest News Network. Don't forget, next Monday, October 14th, school will be closed for Columbus Day.